In the name of Allah, most gracious and most merciful. Dear students, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Yet wow debis mazal shema du watagatu kandagash wuchan, pat zalak to zalun kriut lagi yet asi badal hukar paga. Yet sainras as wagniar wuna tatwen kahi wagniar paga. Yet dasisuit as a doctor of tatibanavandar paga. Thanks to Almighty Allah who gave us the chance to be in conversation with you again. We were unable for some days to meet amid COVID-19, and it never means that we should give up, we should not continue our studies, and that is why I tried to prepare this video for you, so that you will remain connected with the knowledge and you will not lose your heart, you will not give up your studies, and you will go through these circumstances but continuing your studies as well. Today our topic will be intelligence, and some of the theories which have been put forth or laid down to explain or to discuss what intelligence is, and what are its different thoughts which have been given in order to explain this intelligence of human beings. So our agenda will be intelligence, theories, types, explanations. If we get chance, we'll be discussing assessment of intelligence as well, and variations in intellectual ability. Students, there are so many questions which may come up in our minds, or maybe they may come up in your mind as well, that how intelligent a person is, or how I am an intelligent person, or whether I am intelligent or not, or how do we judge if someone is intelligent or not, or there is a question, how can we measure the intelligence of a person? Is intelligence how precisely we learn a new task, or is it how good we are in our studies, or is intelligence how well we can solve our problems? Let us see first of all the word intelligence, what it means. Word intelligence derives from the Latin noun word intelligentia or intellectus, which in turn stem from the verb intelligere, which means to comprehend or perceive. Dear students, you might be thinking now that what is the actual definition of intelligence. Although definition of intelligence is controversial, because some groups of the psychologists have suggested different types of definitions, but a general definition of the intelligence has been given as a very general mental capability that, among other things, involves the ability to reason, plan, solve problems, think abstractly, comprehend complex ideas, learn quickly, and learn from experience. It means that this is the ability, or intelligence is the ability to reason, it is ability to plan anything, it is ability to solve different types of problems in the life. It means that it is ability of a person to think abstractly, or it is how a person comprehends complex ideas, or it may be learning quickly and learn from the experiences. Dear students, you are different types of individuals in front of me, or you are listening to me, or many people may be listening to me. Everyone amongst us is individual to one another, we differ from one another. So when we say that we differ from one another, it means we differ from one another in our ability to understand, in order to understand our complex ideas, or to adapt effectively to the environment, or we may say that we differ to learn from the experiences, we differ in engaging in various forms of reasoning as well. But this all, when we explain these all things of the life, we say that this all pertains to one's intelligence. Although these individual differences can be substantial, but they are never entirely consistent. A given person's intellectual performance will vary on different occasions in different domains as judged by different criteria. Actually, the concepts of intelligence are attempts to clarify and organize this complex set of phenomena. Although considerable clarity has been achieved in some areas, that is why different psychologists have defined this intelligence in different way, and I will be trying to give you all the definitions which the psychologists have given so far. Alfred Binet has been one of the most important psychologists. He says that judgment, otherwise called good sense, practical sense, initiative, the faculty of adapting one's self to circumstances, is intelligence. David Wessler says that intelligence is the aggregate or global capacity of the individual to act purposefully, to think rationally, and to deal effectively with his environment. Howard Gardner, who is a good psychologist, also says that, to my mind, a human intellectual competence, a set of skills of problem solving, enabling the individual to resolve genuine problems or difficulties that he or she encounters, and when appropriate, to create an effective product, and must also entail the potential for finding or creating problems, and thereby laying the groundwork for the acquisition of new knowledge. My students, don't think that we are only talking of human intelligence. There is also non-human intelligence as well. But today we are only discussing this human intelligence, which is the intellectual power of humanness, which is marked by complex cognitive feats and high level of motivation and self-awareness. Intelligence enables humans to remember descriptions of things and use those descriptions in future behaviors. It is a cognitive process. It gives humans the cognitive abilities to learn, form concepts, understand, and reason, including the capacities to recognize patterns, innovate, plan, solve problems, and employ language to communicate. Intelligence enables humans to experience and think. In order to understand intelligence, different psychologists have given so many theories. For example, Sir Francis Galton's theory is there, James McKean-Cattell's theory is there, Spearman's theory of intelligence is there, Thorndike's theory is there, which is also called a social intelligence theory. Thurston's theory of intelligence is there, which have 7 primary mental abilities included. R.B. Kettle and J.L. Horner's theory is there, or we can say crystalline and fluid intelligence, which he says R.B. Kettle and J.L. Horner's theory. Or Gardner's multiple intelligence theory is there. Information processing approaches are there. Practical intelligence is there, or emotional intelligence theories are there. So there are so many theories which have been put forth in order to define or explain what actually intelligence is and what are its modus operandi. But we will be discussing today only Gardner's, or I can say Howard Gardner's multiple intelligence theory. Howard Gardner's multiple factor theory. It has 8 constituents, or I can say there are 8 factors which the Gardner gave us in order to explain this intelligence of a person. He is not of this opinion that intelligence is a single factor, just like other psychologists, but he is of this opinion that the intelligence consists of 8 factors. It is linguistic intelligence is one of the factor, and musical intelligence is there. Then he says that logical, mathematical intelligence is there. And fourth, he says that spatial intelligence is also there. And then he says that it is bodily or kinesthetic intelligence. And one more factor he explains is that intrapersonal intelligence is also there, or interpersonal intelligence is there. And eighth factor which he explains, or which he says in his multiple factor theory, is that naturalist theory. One factor is linguistic intelligence, or we can say it is word smart intelligence of a person. It is the capacity to use language. A person who is having this capacity, or who is having this intelligence, he is more efficient to use language It may be his native language, it may be his mother tongue. If he uses his mother tongue well, if he learns it in a proper way, Gardner says that this person is having this good intelligence, or this factor is included in his intelligence. Here, one thing is implied, so far as you as students, I want to convey over here. You are always after the foreign languages. But does it mean that if we will not be able to learn our own mother tongue, that is Kashmiri, it means that there is a problem in our intelligence? Or perhaps if Gardner has said that this is one of the factors in the intelligence, that is linguistic intelligence or word somewhat intelligence, and if he says that it is the capacity or it is the ability of a person to learn his native language, no doubt he says that it is the ability to learn other languages as well in the world. But if a person forgets his own language, his own mother tongue, and he is not able to learn this, does it mean that this person is devoid of, or he is deficient of this factor in intelligence? There are linguistic intelligence traits. It means a person likes to read, or a person likes to write, a person likes to listen, or a person who is good at spelling, or a person who has a good memory, or a good knowledge about the languages, whether it may be his native language or it may be other languages which he might be learning or she might be learning during studies or in his or her. Another factor of Howard Gardner's multiple intelligence theory is logical mathematical intelligence, or we can say number reasoning somewhat this factor. It means it is the capacity or it is the ability of a person to reason, to calculate, to recognize patterns, and to handle logical thinking. So such persons who have this logical mathematical intelligence factor, they have traits, they like to count, there are traits of these organization, they organize the things, and they are good at problem solving. Number third factor of the multiple intelligence theory of Gardner is spatial intelligence, or the picture somewhat. Such persons are always somewhat in pictures, they capture the pictures, or they are good at drawing, or it means it is the capacity or the intelligence which refers to the ancient hunter-gatherer ability, or to represent the outer world internally in your mind. It gives you the ability to know where you are in space, or there are traits like art, drawing, sculpting, painting, good at reading maps, things in pictures, can visualize or imagine vividly.
Three.
Another factor of this theory is bodily kinesthetic intelligence, or body somewhat intelligence. It means it is the ability or capacity to use whole body or the parts of your body, your hands, your fingers, your arms, to solve a problem, making something or put on some kind of production. Dear students, it means that a person among us to you or outside the class, I can say that if he is able to use hands properly, use fingers properly, use body parts properly to solve the problems, or he is able to make just like the people are having innovative ideas and they make many things, or there are people who work hard with their hands, suppose farmers are there, or scientists are there, or those people who use their body parts, even they use mind, or they use hand, they use legs, they use their arms. That means this factor is very much active in them as per the theory of multiple factors. There are traits which are related to this factor. Is good sense of balance is there, good sense of rhythm is there, they are graceful in movements, or good hand-eye coordination is there, and they can communicate ideas through gestures. आपने देखा होगा कि बहुत सारे लोग जो हैं या बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट जो हैं जो पढ़ने लिखने में तो अच्छे नहीं है, या उनकी जो स्पेलिंग्स हैं वो अच्छी नहीं है, या उनका मैथमेटिक्स अच्छा नहीं है, या एग्जाम्स में दे आर नॉट डूइंग गुड इन एग्जाम्स इन मैथमेटिक्स एंड दे डोंट गेट गुड मार्क्स इन एग्जामिनेशन, बट एट सम ओकेजन्स आर सम इवेंट्स विच योर स्कूल आर सेलिब्रेट एट योर प्लेस, and those students who do not good in mathematics they sing good songs there. What do you think about their intelligence? There is a solution for it. Howard Gardner says that one of the factor in the intelligence is musical intelligence, or it is music smart person. The person is music smart, or he's having this factor properly. I can say this is the capacity or this is the ability to compose songs and music, sing and play instruments and appreciate all kinds of music. Also having a strong sense of universal harmony and awareness of patterns in life. You might have observed that there are a good number of singers throughout the world who have reached the heights. Even they have made their own places in the society, and it does not mean that some of them might have not been good in their studies or in other subjects or in other spheres of life, but they have proved metal in this era or in this sphere or in this intelligence. It means that musical intelligence is one of the important intelligence, important factor in human intelligence. Such people show the traits that is sensitive. They are sensitive to sound patterns and has a good sense of pitch and rhythm. They are aware of complex structures of musical notes. तो फिर आप क्या कहोगे, आप में से जो बच्चे हैं जो कभी कभी नात शरीफ पढ़ते हैं और उनकी जो सुरीली आवाज़ है, तो जब आप उनको चेयर करते हैं, जब आप उनको उनकी हौसला अफजाई करते हैं, तो डजंट इट मीन दैट दे आर गुड इन दिस म्यूजिकल इंटेलिजेंस देयर, और बाकी लोगों से तो इनमें ये एक मुख्तलिफ चीज़ है जो कि आप में से अगर एफिशेंट बच्चे भी हैं जो एग्जाम में बहुत अच्छे नंबर भी लेते हैं, but doesn't it mean those students who do good in this musical part or having this musical intelligence factor there, they are also equivalent to those who are doing good in mathematics or who are doing good in, up to this thing we realize one thing, dear students, that if a person or if a student is not doing good in mathematics but he is doing good in linguistics or languages, it never means that this difference makes anybody dull or this difference makes anybody more intelligent. Dusra jo multiple factor jo theory hai, इसमें इंटरपर्सनल इंटेलिजेंस की जो फैक्टर है वो उसने दिया है. इसका मतलब यह है कि दिस द कैपेसिटी और एबिलिटी टू वर्क वेल विद अदर पीपल और टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड गेट देम और टू बी अवेयर ऑफ देयर मोटिवेशंस, देयर गोल्स, देयर स्टेटेड एंड अनस्टेटेड इंटेंशंस. इट इज अबाउट बीइंग अ पीपल पर्सन और एबल टू एम्पैथाइज विद अदर्स. सो मैं ये कहूँगा कि इंटरपर्सनल इंटेलिजेंस का जो फैक्टर है ये हमें ये बताता है कि एक इंसान कैसे लोगों के साथ उठता बैठता है और वो किस तरह से फिट हो रहा है लोगों के साथ. आपने देखा होगा कि बहुत सारे लोगों के अंदर वो जो गुरूर का सा वो चीज़ होता है कि ये मैं तो इनसे बड़ा हूँ या मैं उनसे कुछ ज़्यादा ही अच्छा हूँ, तो ये चीज़ें जो हैं वो इंटरपर्सनल इंटेलिजेंस में नहीं आती हैं, क्योंकि इंटरपर्सनल इंटेलिजेंस में कैपेसिटी एक है, ये एबिलिटी एक है कि हाउ अ पर्सन वर्क्स वेल विद अदर पीपल. सो हमें यहाँ एक चीज़ का ख्याल रखना पड़ेगा कि हमें तो जहन में गुरूर तो होना ही नहीं चाहिए, और दूसरी बात यह है कि हमें लोगों को समझना पड़ेगा, लोगों की जो भावनाएँ हैं, लोगों के बिहेवियर जो हैं उनको समझना पड़ेगा, लोगों की इज्जत करनी पड़ेगी और लोगों के साथ उठने बैठने में ख्याल रखना पड़ेगा. दैट इज़ वाई गॉर्डनर हैज़ गिवन दिस फैक्टर वन ऑफ द इम्पोर्टेंट फैक्टर in his multiple factor theory that interpersonal intelligence is there, people smart intelligence is there, and those people who are having this factor in a proper way, they work in a efficient manner. Interpersonal traits are there. He is good at negotiating. You might have seen that there are people, or there are countries, or there are tribes as well, when there is any kind of conflict between them, but one of the tribe or one of the country or one amongst the other comes in easily for negotiations, and they want to come on the table. So there is a difference between the people. They differ from one another in this factor as well, interpersonal factor. And interpersonal factor gives rise to the trait. That trait is how we have to negotiate with one another. If the person is able to negotiate, or he comes for the negotiation, it means that this factor is prevalent there, and he enjoys the company when he works with the company. Company does not mean any factory here. Company means the friends, company means the neighbors. When the person works with them, when the person comes in negotiation with them, it means that this factor is prevailing there, and he gets on well with others. This is one of the trait, and he likes teamwork. So teamwork is to be given preference, and he is sensitive to feelings of others. Once he is sensitive to feelings of others, it means that this factor is present in his intelligence or in her intelligence. And you might be knowing these days, amid COVID-19, how we must feel one's problem. If the person is not feeling in such circumstances, it means that interpersonal intelligence is less there, or is not present there, or we can say that he is deficient of this factor in his intelligence. So we all must keep in our mind that we have to work efficiently, and we have to work in a team manner. One more important factor which is included in this Gardner's multiple factor theory of intelligence, which is intrapersonal intelligence or self-smart. You must not be confused with interpersonal intelligence and intrapersonal intelligence. Interpersonal intelligence means it is the capacity or the ability of a person that how he behaves with other people. But intrapersonal intelligence, which I am going to discuss now, or the self-smart intelligence, it is the ability or the capacity to access, understand, and communicate one's own inner feelings. Dear students, you are having your own feelings, I am having my own feelings. Every person has his own feelings and emotions. If a person is able to understand, able to access, if he is able to communicate one's own feelings, then we can say that intrapersonal intelligence factor is there. It means that a person is self-smart. He understands himself. He knows his feelings. He expresses his feelings. He understands his or her emotions. And then he expresses his feelings and emotions. There are the traits which are related with this intrapersonal intelligence, that is self-knowledge. It means that a person is having knowledge about himself, who the person is. Suppose if we will touch over here, that a person says that I am a human being and I have been created by the Almighty Allah. It means that he knows his creation, and he wants to know his creation. There may be persons in the world who may not be knowing this, or who may not be of this opinion that we have been created by someone, but they might be thinking that we have been created overnight over here without the without any power. But the human being who understands his feelings, who understands his emotions, and then expresses his feelings and emotions, we can say that intrapersonal intelligence is present there. And another trait which is related with this is that he is deeply aware of his own feelings, and he is good at following instinct. Okay, you might not be forgetting, we have completed 7 factors till now, and 8th one, which is naturalist intelligence. It is nature somewhat factor of intelligence given by Howard Gardner. It means it is the capacity or it is the ability to see patterns in nature and work in natural environment with livestock, wildlife, plants, etc. And the traits which are related with this factor of intelligence is that one feels at their best in nature, sensitive to ecology, sensitive to environmental and animal abuse. It means that a person who has much more ability or who is a nature loving person. I mean to say that if a person or if a boy or if a girl or if a man, if a woman is nature loving, he loves nature, he likes nature, he works with nature, he wants to preserve nature, he keeps eye on the different types of pollution which eradicate the things in our environment, degrades our environment, degrades our natural resources, and it means that he is having this naturalist intelligence factor in his or her intelligence. It gives us one thought that all the people on the earth should have rational thinking about the nature, and he must work for the nature, and he must not do the things which are against the nature. Here you see that nature is biotic and abiotic, nature is living and non-living as well. Here you see that animals are there, birds are there, plants are there, wildlife is there, and one must have passion to keep an eye over all these things, whether balance of these things is there. There is no imbalance of nature. We are talking of imbalance now, and you see that in the nature ozone layer is depleting. One must care for it, one must be very much cautious about all these things, so that it shows that a person who is having this factor prominent in his or her intelligence, he keeps an eye over all these things and he cares for these things. And you might have seen there are many people who don't care for these things, but it means that they are having a low level of intelligence in this factor, or I can say that he is not much efficient in this factor, and he is having some problem in this factor. Now, students, let us sum up. Does it mean that these all 8 factors, which are given by the Gardner in his multiple factor intelligence theory, does it mean that one person may have one factor in his intelligence at a time or all? No, you must not be confused. Every person has all these factors in his intelligence, because intelligence is combination of all these factors. But as per the Gardner, some people may exhibit one factor at a time or all factors at a time, or he may get a chance to use one factor of his intelligence at a time. It means that each person has every one of these intelligences. He is not deficient of any intelligence, rather. It means that if a person is doing good in music, he can also do good in mathematics if he is provided chance. It means that there is no difference between the people on this basis. We can't say a student that he is dull. If he is getting chance, he can do well in all factors, and he can exhibit all factors at any certain point of time. You might have seen that people who were considered not good during his studies time, but in later life they were got a good chance and they proved themselves. Suppose if you talk about the Albert Einstein, you might have heard that Albert Einstein failed in matriculation, but later on he proved to be a scientist. How it is possible? You might have You might have gone through the biographies of other scientists as well, or other educationists as well. They have not proved good at their studies level, but in later life they have proved good. So if a person gets chance, his multiple factors of intelligence can prove him at that very event. One more thing which we must keep in our mind is that people are stronger in some intelligences and weaker in others. So it is occasional. One may be strong at one point of time in one intelligence factor, and at that very point of time he would be weaker in other factor, but with the passage of time he may become stronger in other factors as well. So the idea of standard intelligence does not sufficiently encompass the different abilities that humans have. We are short of time, you know it well, and now I will ask you some questions. What is intelligence, and what are different definitions given by the psychologists in order to define intelligence? And can you tell me, or you can write it down, you can jot it down, that what are different theories of intelligence, and what are the postulates, or what are the factors given by the Howard Gardner in his multiple factor intelligence?